Imagine a really important deadline is coming closer and closer, and you are already working long hours to make it. But then, suddenly, your laptop breaks, and all the files are on it. That's what happened to me a few weeks ago during my research project. I quickly realized that if I want to make it, I truly need support. I remember that day, sitting at my office desk and looking around for help. But nobody was in the office, apart from my colleague Tom. I wondered if I could ask him and if he had even time. But with the deadline in mind, I wanted to give it a shot, so I walked over to his desk. I explained him my problem and went straight to the point. "Hey Tom, listen, I truly need your support. Can you do some research for me?" "Yeah, sure," he said. "Just give me a few more details and I'll research that for you." Wow, I didn't expect that. Afterwards, I organized a temporary commuter and started working on my own. But I was so slow with this new commuter and didn't have all the files I needed. I thought about getting help from Tom once more, but can I ask him again? I ended up asking again. And just as last time, he was eager to help. He supported me with brainstorming lots of ideas and also implementing them afterwards. In the upcoming days, it went on like this. And 2 weeks later, I actually managed the deadline, which seemed unreachable a couple of days before, thanks to the help of Tom. You might say now, "Well, Toby, that is nice for you. But what if I ever need support? There is not always randomly this one colleague over there having nothing better to do than helping me 24/7, right?" Well, what if Tom is available to all of us? What? How? Let me explain. Tom was just a random name and is not even a person. It was rather a digital assistant easily accessible 24/7. The assistant is based on a technology you probably have heard of: generative artificial intelligence. So, why did I not tell you that from the very beginning? Because I want you to focus on how you can apply the technology, not the technology itself. There's too much hype about it. At the end of the day, it is just a tool, but we have to learn how and for what we can use it. It's like when our ancestors started using the hammer thousands of years ago. It was a new powerful tool, and they could build faster, better, etc. But in the beginning, some might have grabbed the hammer on the wrong side or used it as a toothbrush. This can be dangerous. It cannot do everything. But those who learned how to master the hammer were empowered by this new tool. As for the hammer back then, I realized that many people have already played around with these assistants, but are far away from using them effectively. So let's go back to the story from the beginning and let me share with you how and for what I used my assistant. On the first day, I wanted to learn more about team performance. Instead of scrolling through hard-to-understand websites, I just asked the questions I had. I still had to leverage my old way of learning, since not everything was true. But because of the conversational aspect, I realized I was having much more fun learning new things than ever before. It sparked my curiosity. Afterwards, I wanted to know which audio features can predict team performance. Instead of brainstorming alone, I just asked again. I couldn't use it as my trustworthy source, since some topics did not make sense for my use case. But it gave me lots of ideas I would have never thought of. It fostered my creativity. And the last days until the deadline, I wanted to implement some of these ideas. Instead of doing everything by myself, I just texted the questions I had and got the code as answer back. I had to double check the results, since smaller parts did not work as expected. But as I kept exploring the limits, I discovered more and more use cases, which is why I was way more productive. With the help of the assistant, I was not only more productive, but I also had much more fun and felt more creative. I found out that the assistant is particularly helpful for me in the areas learn, ideate, create. But to figure this out, I had to intensively engage with the assistant, test its limits, and be aware of the flaws that weren't immediately obvious. It was just like the hammer, a tool. The better I knew how to handle it, the more I got out of it. In the end, the tool was only as good as I made it to be. As these tools continue to evolve and become part of our daily lives, it's crucial that we learn how to use them properly. Whether it's molecule design or getting inspiration where to travel next, there are countless ways in which they can enhance your experiences. Most of us have already heard about these tools or tried them out, but only few have discovered their true value. So if you want to be among the few who truly harness their full potential, take the time to intensively engage with such an assistant and explore its limits. There are many more stories to write. This was just mine. Tom always has time for you. So what is your story? You don't have to wait until the most intensive days of your life. Thanks.